Hey guys, so in class we started section 10.1, graphing trig functions, and we graphed sine x and cosine x. And so in this video we're going to continue with tangent x, and we're going to start the same way we did in class. We're going to start by basically plugging in points. If y equals tangent x, here are some different x values. I'm going to plug them into tangent and see what I get. So if x is negative pi over 2, what's tangent x? I can use my tangent as y over x and evaluate that, which we did on the last test. If you're still struggling with that, let me know and we can work on that together. But tangent of negative pi over 2 is undefined, which is interesting. We didn't get that for any values in sine and cosine. That'll make this graph look kind of different. Tangent of negative pi over 3 is negative root 3. Tangent of negative pi over 4 is negative 1. Negative pi over 6 is negative root 3 over 3. And tangent of 0 is 0. So these are values we know from using our tangent of theta equals y over x formula and our special right triangles. We get these values. If we continue, we get actually a lot of the same looking numbers, but they'll be positive now. So we get root 3 over 3, tangent of pi over 4 is positive 1, tangent of pi over 3 is root 3, and tangent of pi over 2, just like tangent of negative pi over 2, is undefined. Now, I'm not sure how to graph an undefined point. We'll figure that out in a second. But let's start by plotting these points. It'll help to know that root 3 is about 1.7, and root 3 over 3 is about 0.6. Okay, let's plot these points. Negative pi over 3, so on my, I've got my graph here going from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. Here's x equals 0. Halfway between 0 and pi over 2 would be pi over 4. So this right here is pi over 6. And this is pi over 3. And here we've got negative pi over 6, and negative pi over 3. So negative pi over 3 comma 1.7 gets me down here. Negative pi over 4 comma negative 1 is this coordinate right here. Negative pi over 6 comma negative 0.6, I don't know, about there. 0, 0. Pi over 6 comma 0.6. Pi over 4 comma 1. Pi over 3, 1.7. So it looks like tangent is doing something like this. Now let's see if we can figure out what's going on with these undefined points. What we find out looking at the graph is that the closer I get to pi over 2 and negative pi over 2, the more tangent goes up. And so what happens at pi over 2, where it's undefined, is there's a vertical asymptote. And remember, an asymptote is a line that the graph gets closer and closer and closer to without ever touching. And so this graph is going to continue down towards that asymptote without ever touching it. And the other side is going to continue up towards the asymptote without ever touching it. This is one period of y equals tangent x. Okay, one period of y equals tangent x. Let's go ahead and label the information for this graph like we did in class. So what is its domain? Well, unlike sine and cosine, and actually, you know what, to do this, let's look at the picture in the book, which shows us the period we just graphed from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, but it also shows us all the periods to the right and to the left, or a few of them. So unlike sine and cosine, there are gaps in this graph where there are asymptotes. And so the domain isn't all real numbers anymore. Now the domain is, here's how we're going to write it. We're going to write all real numbers except odd multiples of pi over 2. All real numbers except odd multiples of pi over 2. Odd multiples of pi over 2 are 1 pi over 2, negative 1 pi over 2, 3 pi over 2, 5 pi over 2, 7 pi over 2, all the odd numbers. The range, though, unlike sine and cosine that are restricted, they only go up to 1 and down to negative 1. The range of tangent is that it goes up forever and down forever. And so the range we write all real numbers. One thing that means for tangent is that unlike sine and cosine, there's no maximum value or minimum value because tangent just goes up forever. And so there's no maximum, no minimum, and there's no amplitude for tangent x. Those are terms we only use for waves like sine and cosine. The period is, remember, how far I have to go, the distance I have to go before the graph starts repeating itself. And again, let's look at the graph in the book where I can see multiple periods. Here's the period we graphed from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. If I copy that period and paste it here, I see the exact same thing. So what is that distance I'm going? What is the distance from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2? That distance or period is pi. Remember, the period for y equals sine x and y equals cosine x was 2 pi, so tangent, once again, is a little different. The x-intercepts are where it crosses the x-axis. Notice that happens at 0. It'll happen again at pi and at 2 pi. It'll also happen if I go this way at negative pi. So we'll write it like this. We'll say that the x-intercepts are at 0, plus or minus pi, plus or minus 2 pi, plus or minus 3 pi, and so on. Basically, any integer multiple of pi. Remember, my integers are negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and so on. And I can see that those multiples of pi are the x-intercepts. And lastly, where are the vertical asymptotes? The vertical asymptotes are at the same places the domain doesn't exist. They're at odd multiples of pi over 2. Wherever there was a hole in the domain, all real numbers except odd multiples of pi over 2, that hole exists because there's a vertical asymptote. And so those vertical asymptotes occur at odd multiples of pi over 2. Okay, so this is like our parent function, y equals tangent x. Just like in class with sine and cosine, now we're going to work on changing y equals tangent x. And we're going to graph y equals a tangent of bx, and a and b can be any numbers. And depending on those numbers, it's going to affect the graph. The period of y equals a tangent bx is pi divided by the absolute value of b. In the problem we just did, y equals tangent x, b was 1, and so the period was just pi over 1, aka pi. But if b is some other number, we have to do pi divided by b to get the period. The vertical asymptotes occur at, we already listed this for y equals tangent x, now we'll do it for tangent bx, odd multiples of pi over 2 is what we listed last time, but now with that extra b, it's pi over 2 absolute value of b. Let's look back at our parent function for a second. Notice that, remember in class when we did sine and cosine, there was a start point, an end point, and then we kind of thought of it like a football game. Start of the game, end of the game, there was halftime, first quarter, and third quarter. Tangent has the same thing. It's got the start and end, which are asymptotes for tangent. It's got halftime, which is an x-intercept. And then it's got first quarter and third quarter. And notice that at first quarter and third quarter, which are halfway between the asymptotes and the x-intercept at pi over 4 and negative pi over 4 and positive pi over 4. Notice that the values are negative 1 and positive 1. Okay? So for regular old y equals tangent x, first quarter will be negative 1 and third quarter will be positive 1. But for y equals a tangent of bx, first quarter is going to be, the height of the first quarter point, instead of being 1 or negative 1, will be the absolute value of A, and negative the absolute value of A. In other words, the number in front of tangent x affects how high up and down these first quarter and third quarter points will be. If A is a big number, these points move up. If A is a fraction, these points move down. So we'll look at that in an example. Okay, and lastly, what are the x-intercepts? The x-intercepts are given by their multiples. Multiples of pi over b. So last time we said that they were 0 plus or minus pi, 0 plus or minus pi plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 3 pi. Now they would be 0 plus or minus pi over b plus or minus 2 pi over b plus or minus 3 pi over b, and so on. Okay, let's try an example. Graph 1 period of y equals 3 tangent 1 half x, identify the domain, range, and period, and label 3 points and 2 vertical asymptotes. In other words, label the start, end, halftime, first quarter, and third quarter. 5 pieces of information, 3 of which will be points and 2 of which will be vertical asymptotes. Okay, let's do it. So let's find the period. Remember, the period is going to be pi over b, and in this case, b is 1 half. Pi over b. I'm dividing by a fraction, which means I multiply by the reciprocal of the fraction. 2 times pi is 2 pi. There's my period. Okay, now this can be a little tricky for tangent. The period of a regular tangent graph is pi because the distance from pi halves to negative pi halves, the distance between this is pi. And if you're not sure, just do pi over 2 minus negative pi over 2, and you'll see that your answer is pi. That's the distance. If the period of a normal tangent graph is pi, I have to go halfway out from the y-axis, that's pi over 2, and halfway out from the y-axis in the other direction, that's pi over 2. So I went half of a period in either direction. When you're doing tangent, not only is it good to know the period, it's also good to think, what's half of that period? What's half of 2 pi? Half of 2 pi is 1 pi, and that's the distance from the y-axis I'm going to go. I'm going to go 1 pi in either direction, which brings me from negative pi to pi. Now remember, at tangent, the vertical asymptotes are at the start of the game and the end of the game. Here are my vertical asymptotes. They're labeled at negative pi and pi. The equations of these lines, if you're interested, are x equals pi and x equals negative pi. That's the equation of these vertical asymptotes. Remember that halfway between start of the game and end of the game, at halftime, is the x-intercept. And that's going to be true here as well. So what happens at the first quarter and the third quarter of this game? Remember, the first quarter is halfway between negative pi and 0. What's halfway between negative pi and 0? Negative pi over 2. What's halfway between 0 and pi? Positive pi over 2. So I've got my 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 key x values labeled. Start of the game, end of the game, halftime, first quarter, third quarter. I've got my asymptotes. I've got my x-intercept. And the last thing to do is these first quarter and third quarter points. And remember, the height of the first quarter and third quarter points is the absolute value of A. For this particular problem, A is 3, which means at third quarter, I'm going to be up to y equals 3. And at first quarter, I'm going to go down to y equals negative 3. Here's my tangent graph. I've got my start of the game and end of the game asymptotes labeled for tangent. I've got halftime x-intercept. I've got my first quarter and my third quarter, and the height is dependent upon the number in front of tangent x, which is 3, right there. So it went up 3 and down 3 instead of up 1 and down 1 for just plain old y equals tangent x. All right, cool. There's my graph. Let's make sure I've got all the information I asked for. I've got my period. I need to state the domain and the range. Now for tangent x, the range is the easy one. All real numbers. This graph goes up and down forever. The domain is a little trickier. It's going to be all real numbers, except where I have an asymptote, because the function doesn't ever cross these points. It doesn't exist there, and so that's not in the domain. Remember, the asymptotes happen at odd multiples of pi over 2b. B in this case is 1/2. So all real numbers, let's find out what pi over 2 times 1/2 is. 2 times 1/2 is 1. Pi over 1 is just pi. So all real numbers except odd multiples of pi. Okay, I've got my domain, my range, my period. Oops, you can't really see that, sorry. I've labeled my asymptotes, x equals negative pi and x equals pi. And it's clear from my graph that this is 0, 0, pi over 2, comma 3, and negative pi over 2, comma negative 3. Okay? So here's the problem I'd like you to do at the end of your notes. It's page 616, number 17. I'll project it in a second. And remember to bring in your notes and this problem to class. And in this chapter, we're going to try not doing that thing where you have to summarize the notes. I don't really think that worked too well. And so I just want you to bring into class, I want you to bring in your notes with these examples, and I want you to bring in this problem. And here it is. Page 616, number 17. Now it's circled, which means it's worked out both online and in the book, so you can take a look at that to help you. The instructions are to graph the function, and the function is f of x equals 4 tangent x. And we're going to start tomorrow's class by going over this problem and by answering any other questions you have. And then I'll have some more problems for you to work on in class from section 10.1. I'll see you then.